Hi everyone, this is Dr. Nitin Choda with Ignition Time and welcome to my show. In this video, I'll give you the latest status of the stimulus negotiations. I'll give you some important updates about the $300 a week federal booster, which is the lost wages assistance program that was set up by the president's executive actions. And number three, I'll show you an interesting graph that tells you that some of the temporary job losses are seemingly going to be permanent, and it seems more and more individuals are now coming to terms with this reality. Once again, my name is Dr. Nitin Choda. Welcome to my channel. If you don't know anything about me, please check out my introductory video on the channel where you get to learn a little bit about me, how I have the honor, the privilege of living my American dream. And I promise you, when this is over, I will help you reach your American dream, even though it may not look like it right now. Thank you so much for watching. Let's jump right into it. As far as the stimulus negotiations go, as we speak, there's a hearing going on with the United States Postal Service Postmaster General Louis DeJoy and several lawmakers, and there's a lot of confusion. There are audiovisual problems, there are technical problems. Lawmakers are using up all their time as opposed to asking questions about the post office, and it is quite a mess. So there is really, at this point in time, no real consensus, no real progress of the stimulus negotiations, and I'll let you know if and when there's any progress on that aspect. We know that there were some overtures made over the weekend by the administration to try and get in touch with House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, but nothing worthwhile has materialized from those outreach measures at the time I'm recording this. Now, as far as the $300 a week go, FEMA did indeed approve New York for the $300 a week benefits yesterday. In addition, and this is brand new reporting from Jeff Stein at the Washington Post, here's an update from the Department of Labor. You'll see this tweet from Jeff Stein. Texas actually started paying the $300 a week today. So this is the second state. Remember, the first state was Arizona. Arizona started paying their residents as early as last week, the $300 a week. And Louisiana is going to be the third state that starts paying the $300 this week, probably by the end of this week. As you probably know, South Dakota has said no. And 46 states, over 45 states, are yet, you know, to be determined, because some of them have applied, some of them are pending approval, and that's where things stand right now. And many, many, many states, as you can see on Jeff's Twitter feed, and I've reported this on my channel as well, many of them have said late September, or it could be a few weeks before we can start seeing any concrete stimulus. In other words, before their residents can start seeing the $300 a week deposited into their bank accounts. Now, keep in mind, this $300 a week is retroactive. It will go back to August 1st, but it'll only last a few weeks, because we're talking about $45 billion in funding, which, when you distribute that amongst millions of individuals, is not projected to last very long, especially when you consider that's going to be retroactive. I did mention that I believe the president's executive orders were not designed to be a permanent solution, because they can't be. The funds have to be appropriated by Congress. So they were essentially intended as a way to buy time, as a way to create a stopgap, if you will. Also on your screen, you'll see a tweet from Sam Rowe, who's a managing editor of Yahoo Finance. And as you can see from this chart, the percentage of workers, the share of workers who were laid off temporarily that expect to return to the same job, dropped significantly in the month of July. It's actually amazing when you look at this chart. If you look at the dark blue portion of this chart, these are the individuals who definitely or probably will return to the same job. And remember, they were temporarily laid off. And you can see that dark blue line is on its way down. So the share of workers that expect to return to the same job dropped significantly in the month of July. And that light blue portion shows individuals who definitely or probably will not return to their jobs. That's on the uptick. So as a direct result of this crisis, and remember, we're talking about almost 30 million individuals who are unemployed at the time I'm recording this. Individuals are coming to terms with the reality that they will not be returning to the job that they had. And in some cases, we've had, you know, my viewers, subscribers have had the same job for decades. So the percentage of individuals who were temporarily laid off who are going to return to their same job, they know, and there is a growing sense of consensus. There's a growing reality. Again, take a look at this chart. There's a growing reality that they will not return to the same job. And there was essentially a surge of this sentiment in July. On the other hand, individuals who felt that they would essentially be laid off probably won't return was on the way up. So people are not expecting their old jobs to come back, plain and simple. And again, this is from Sam Rowe, who is the managing editor at Yahoo Finance. That's it, everybody. My name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you thought of this. Let me know in the comment section below. Have you been temporarily laid off? Do you expect to return to the same job? And for that matter, are you already looking for something new? And what are your prospects of getting your old job back? Or do you expect to be in a new position? Do you expect to re-engineer your skills and find something new, find a new opportunity? Let me know in the comment section below where you're at. Once again, my name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda. Thank you so much for watching. Please click like, please click subscribe. If you learn something new, please enable notifications so you get instant updates from us going forward. If you want to get alerts from us, get your cell phone out, send a text message with the word ignition or with the word time to 70,000, that's 70000, and you can get added to our SMS alerts list. You can also get emails from us, and you can opt out of the emails at any time. Also, we release videos at 2 p.m. East Coast time, most days of the week. So make sure you're subscribed to our channel so you get those updates. Once again, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video at Ignition Time. Take care. Bye.